I'd like the topic about the stroke care management in Indonesia. Sorry? Okay, this public disclosure. So, as you may know, that Indonesia is like the other Southeast Asia population, that we are the archipelago country, and then we have 18,000 island, and I think it's difficult for us to use the mothership strategy for stroke, because most of the patient come to the primary hospital and then revert to the stroke hospital. And then nowadays is that the CT scan is, I think Indonesia is the main imaging modality available in the emergency room. And until now that we have 9 comprehensive stroke centers and hospitals, and mostly in the western part of Indonesia. And so this the big problem of stroke management in Indonesia, because there's a big gaps between the eastern and western part of Indonesia. So this is my hospital. It's located in the East Java province. It's an old hospital. We have 1,500 beds, and we treat many traumatic cases and also stroke. So the government's try to speed up the stroke service, and then that's why we rebuilt our the service, the new NGO system introduced in the early of this year, and then also we have our new NCCU, and it hopes that it can give the stroke treatment better in our region. And this is one of the sample case where the adult male with a last seen well is 5 hours before admitted to hospital with a high NI score is 18 and aspect score 8. And then we can see the hyperdensity of the distal aneurysm M1 that is suggestive of hyperacute thromboembolic stroke. And it's the typical how the patient stroke come to the hospital with the CT scan. And then the dorsal puncture is about 90 minutes. And then this is the algorithm how in the hospital, because we have a CT scan in the ER only, so that's why we put the patient into 2 different categories with a high stroke score and a low stroke score. And then it means if the patient is referred from the previous hospital, and then they go directly to the NGO seat, and then we differ with the LP or not. And but if the patient is in the low stroke score, and then we go to the CT scan first in the ER, and then decided whether this is LVO or not, and then go into the angio seat. So this is the previous patient that's groin puncture was performed after 6 hours, and we performed with the under general anesthesia, and then from the DSA we confirmed that the occlusion on the superior M2 division, and then we did the mechanical thrombectomy using stent retriever only, and then we canalized it in 64 minutes. So that's the post-thrombectomy course. That's hospitalization day 2, that NIS score had decreased significantly to 7, and then we did the MRI and saw that increased to the CBF. And the patient discharged at the day 9 with an NSS score of 9, and we follow up the patient with no evidence of recurrent stroke and the second and the 6 month of follow up. Here, this male, the 60 years old, with present with unresponsiveness, and it's 4 hours before admitted to the emergency room, and then from the NCCT, head NCCT, we can see the hyperdense basilar artery sign that then go directly to the NGO suite, and then we can recognize with the aspiration catheter for the basilar occlusion. And then for recognize in a short time, we should select suitable method for the case, and then we have aspiration stand or combination between two. In Indonesia, I think now is the majority we use the stent retriever, then aspiration, and it's quite difficult to have a combined technique, because due to the still the limited budget from the government. This is another case that 8 years old female with a pediatric stroke case, I think, was referred with a severe face drooping and left hemiplegia, and then presented to primary hospital 2 hours after her last unwell. Then it's interesting that his history of trauma 1 week prior, that she had a transient loss of consciousness and headache after slipped to the ground, and then the patient arrived at emergency department at hours, and the initial pediatric NIS score was 14. This is the CT scan 2 hours after the last seen well period, and then go to the MRI, and then you can see that from the diffusion there's a hyper intense, and also you can see that's a M1 segment occlusion. And then we did the DSA, and then with the mechanical thrombectomy 10 hours after her onset, and then also the stenosis dissecting segment that we unfortunately could not open during the thrombectomy, but the condition is getting better actually after 12 hour thrombectomy, and then we did the NCCT evaluation that's suggestive the post-contrast staining, and then the pediatric NSS score decreased to 6, and then at the day 10 the patient discharged home, and the MS follow up at 2nd and 6th month was quite good, and with residual left arm spasticity and left drop foot. This is another the pediatric stroke case that we had recently. That's this is the M1 occlusion for the female 13 years old, and then the pediatric NSS is 17, and then aspect score was 6, and then we did the mechanical thrombectomy. So we quite have some many cases of the pediatric stroke, and then so we try to see the evidence, and we knew that from the previous study that the thrombolysis in pediatric stroke is quite considered in the children, and then from the recent guideline in 2015 that in the pediatric populations that EVT may be reasonable, and then the recent publication from the case control study that the better clinical outcome with thrombectomy than medical management alone in a pediatric patient aged 2 to 18 years with the anterior LVA stroke. So how about this one? This is quite open. CT scan, the patients come to the hospital with a late onset of stroke that we we do nothing for this case, but from the RCT for the large ischemic region that from the many countries, we can see that we try to do the patient with the aspect score 3 to 5, and then interestingly that from the previous presentation that the aspect score 0 to 2 in Vietnam, our colleges already tried to recognize with a good result. Maybe we should conduct the same the same study to see whether we can treat the patient with a late onset stroke and then with the low aspect score. So in conclusion, that in Indonesia, stroke has a major impact in medical service, and that's why the government conducts stroke national program nowadays. And we think that international collaboration, especially in Southeast Asia region, is important to share experience and knowledge. And you can see here, it's our workshop last month. So we would like to invite all of you in to share your knowledge experience in Indonesia to give us a better insight how to treat stroke in the future. Thank you very much.